Hello there, and thank you very much for joining us in this new Azure Portal how-to video. Today, we'll learn how to create and query an Azure SQL database, and for that we have Nina Numa, who is going to show us how to do that. So thank you very much for joining us.
Thanks, Leon. Thanks for having me. Hello, everyone. Like Leon said, we're going to create a SQL database. If you're unfamiliar with SQL database, it's a high-performance, reliable cloud database. You can, you know, if you have a data-driven application or a website that you want to create a database to support it, you can use any programming language that you prefer, and you don't have to manage any of the infrastructure. So we'll go ahead and create a database. Go to create a resource. SQL database is right here. You could use the quick start tutorial if you weren't watching this video to walk you through it. So if we go to create, if you're familiar with any of the other videos or creating a resource, you're familiar with this experience and basics. You have just the bare minimum that you would need to do to create the database. At the very least, you need to enter a database name, and you could go ahead and click create right away, very easy. But we'll walk through a couple of the other things that you can do in case you, wanted to customize it a bit. So first is the project details. For any resource you want to create, you need to specify a subscription and a resource group. Or the resource group, you could use sort of a folder or a bucket. You put all the related resources together. You manage policies, permissions. Once you're done with it, you just can delete it, and you're all good. And then we've entered the database name. I select a server and a region for the database, or I could create a new one. If I had a large number of databases that I wanted to manage the performance and the cost together, I could put it in an elastic pool. But we're just kind of testing things out today, so I'm going to have just a single database and a low-end tier, leave it at the default. And then the last thing that I'm going to want to do is fill the database with some sample data so I can play around and query it later, like Leon said. I could also fill it with a backup if I had a former database, but by default it's just going to be an empty database. I can do whatever I want with it. And that's all I need to do. I'm going to go to review and create. See, it's running some validation, make sure there's no errors, I didn't make any mistakes. Then I can, have one final look at the cost of the database, make sure I'm familiar with all of the settings and defaults that were entered, make sure I'm happy with everything. And then I go ahead and just click create.
And at this point, with this very little information that you provided, you are creating a full database in the cloud, right?
Yep.
That's very nice. And this experience, again, like you mentioned, is the same that we use for any other resource, like storage accounts, virtual machines, et cetera.
Mm-hmm. Try to make it as simple and clear as possible. Just the bare minimum things that you can do, but you can customize anything else after that.
Very nice.
So then while it's creating, we have this nice deployment status blade that gives us a play-by-play of what's going on when we're creating. In this case, we only have one database, one resource creating. Sometimes there are a number of resources, and we'll see that as it happens. In the meantime, I'm going to go back and look at an active database and take a look at the overview status of that database and what I can see there. And then in the meantime, the create will have a notification that lets us know when the database is ready to be looked at. All right, so I have this database that has some activity. I can look at the compute and storage usage, see if there are any problems. If there were any notifications, I would get that right here. If there's alerts, any performance recommendations, things that I'd want to pay attention to. Otherwise, I just get this set of features. So I can see, I'm not using georeplication. Is that important to me? I can configure that from right here.
So basically from here you can see all the options that are available to set up your database and with one click get to them and configure that database.
Yep.
Very nice.
All right, looks like the database is not quite done. That's all right, I have a backup. We'll go take a look and we'll go to the query editor. This is a great feature where I can, if I want to query or edit my data, I can do it right from the portal. I don't have to exit, go somewhere else, go into SQL Server Management Studio. I can just go right here. And I can either, I have Azure Active Directory, I have my account on this server, so I could go ahead and just click, or I can enter my credentials and create, or log in that way.
And in this case, you decided to use Active Directory.
Mm-hmm. It's very convenient. I didn't have to enter my password. I could do it either way. It just automatically connected me, and I just click OK. And so if I want to query the database, just checking on the sample data that's in here, I can run really quick. Under a second, it ran this query, and I can take a look at all the data that's in these tables. And here on the side, I can view my tables, views, stored procedures. Say I just want to go to the customer table, and I want to edit my data. Right? I need to still a preview feature, so I accept the terms. And then right, it opens another tab. I'm going to see all of the data in this table.
So basically, you can inspect the schema and everything that is available to you in the database?
Yep. So I can see, right, if I expand on this table, it'll give me that full schema, all the columns that are actually in this table. All right, so I get that full list, sort of a light version of SQL Server Management Studio. I get the basic things that I need if I want to access my data. Sorry.
So basically, you can either write your own queries or you can explore by clicking and going through the schema.
Mm-hmm. So right, once all of this has loaded, right, I can go through, I can edit any of the cells in this table. If I, you know, want to change a customer's name, if I want to add a new customer, I can just add a row and start entering all the information there. If I'm not super familiar with writing T-SQL queries, I could just edit the data. I don't have to figure out, you know, how do I create a row and add all of the data. I can just edit it right here in place.
That's perfect. All in the portal without installing any additional tool.
Yep.
In the convenience of your browser, right?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much, Ninar. And thanks every one of you for watching. Please leave us a comment in the comment section or follow us on Twitter. Look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.